Hello, and welcome to the Knife Tool Tessellation demonstration video. Your goal here is to take one of the square or triangular tessellations you made previously, and what you want to do is customize it so that it is no longer just a plain black and white or one of the other color. You want to use the Knife Tool and some of the other tools in Illustrator to make it look much more interesting. So, what I'm going to do is open both my basic triangular tessellation shape and my square tessellation shape for basic and advanced. And I'm going to use kind of my choice of which one of these shapes I think is going to be most suitable for the knife. I'm going to make a new document. And it'll be probably letter size. I think that will be fine. Just go ahead and throw last name. Because the goal is we want to make a pattern, but we don't want it to look as plain as some of the ones that we made previously. So I'm going to grab with the white direct selection arrow one copy of each one of my shapes. I'm going to press Control C to copy. I'll go to the Knife Tool, press Control V to paste, and so there's my basic shape. My advanced square tessellation, I will select and copy. I'll go to my triangular tessellation. I'll grab one of these, Control C to copy, Control V to paste. So I brought them all in. What I'm going to do is select each of them, and I'm going to make them all have a black filling color. Because when I'm figuring out what I want to do with the knife tool, it's really important to treat this almost like some type of Rorschach inkblot test. When I look at this shape here, I can kind of see like a ghost with his arms up, popping out. I can see a guy with a nose and his mouth here and a chin. Maybe that's his hair. Kind of a bird or some other type of shape. I see a bit of a bird head up here. So I'm looking for something that might jump out. I see like a horse over in this section, kind of a bird and a guy. So I'm going to probably do a knife tool adjustment with every one of these, but I'll start with my triangle. Okay. First off, I don't want to lose my progress, so I'm immediately going to save it. I'll just save it right on the desktop or my H drive, wherever makes sense for me. Now, I also am immediately going to make a duplicate copy. If I'm going to use this shape here, I am going to hold down the Alt key and click and drag the unchanged shape. I'm keeping that in reserve over on the left, because I'm going to use my knife tool and carve up this guy, and so I got to be ready and willing to fix it if I make a mistake, so that's why I keep another copy over here. Now, I press the letter D, and that gives me the default fill and stroke, white fill, black stroke. It's going to be a little easier to see. I see some funny things happening. I see like a person's head and a fist, and like some funky hair and an ear, and this looks like a horse. So I'm going to make some kind of crazy guy riding a horse. Let's see if we can make this happen. So I'm going to select it, and then the first thing I have to do is find my knife tool. If I click and hold on the eraser icon, the knife tool is underneath. You know me, I don't like to do that. I want to see it right floating on this window, so I'm going to grab the tear off the floating window. Now, I'll go ahead and cut where I think the chin of a little horseback riding guy will be. So what that effectively does is I cut through my shape. Now I have two different shapes. I have this guy, and then a horse.
Okay.
I don't know if I'm going to keep these colors, but maybe I want this guy to be blonde hair, so I will come down and up. Okay, so I've drawn a bit of a hairline. Now, here's the trick. You only need to use the knife tool when you're actually cutting through an object. If I want to put a set of eyes on this guy, I don't need the knife tool at all. I could just take the circle tool and take maybe some other fun tool. I'll use the blob brush. I will make a... I deleted that. I didn't need to do that. I'm going to shrink down the blob brush and make a pupil. There we go. I've just designed an eye. As long as this does not stick halfway out and it ruins the silhouette, if it stays in the interior of my shape, I'm fine. Okay. I could even have another one of these. Okay. If I want one of his eye, behind the other eye. Good. The only problem is it is going over the outside. That I can't have. So I'm going to use Pathfinder. I'm going to divide these two. So what I've effectively done is I've separated the part that was sticking out past the silhouette. My white selection arrow, I can select and delete, and there's a little tiny piece sticking out and causing trouble.
Okay.
So now I've got some eyes. So I want to draw a little nose and the pencil tool. Okay, make a little nose. Okay, I probably don't want a fill color. Or I could choose the same fill color as skin tone, whatever works. I can adjust the thickness of the stroke. Maybe I want that to be a little bit thinner.
Okay. So I need a mouth.
Okay. So what I'm going to do is draw a mouth. Maybe I will use the knife tool for this because I want the mouth to be intersected with the side of the face. So I'm going to control-click just the head. Okay. So if I make a cut here, it only cuts the head. What I want to do is just carve a nice, crazy, Joker-esque mouth. That's and then I have a mouth. Okay, I will go ahead and carve some teeth into this mouth. Let's see. It's going to end up looking pretty creepy. So, give it a try.
Alright.
Yeah, it's a little creepy, but I said it looked like a Joker, so what the heck, let him have that kind of intense lipstick.
And then, just to make him look a little more creepy, I'm going to give him some bangs.
Alright. So now, nice. Alright, so I've got this weird looking vampire Joker cowboy character. Alright, he's got his teeth. Maybe I want to give him a tongue. So, carve a tongue into here. Maybe this is magenta. Okay. I like where I'm going so far. I'm going to save it. I've got my creepy looking fellow here. Let me go ahead and draw a little notch for the ear. Yeah, I want that to have a black stroke weight. That looks cool. I'm going to nudge down my arrows.
Alright, so now I can make this look like a horse.
So, I think that looks like an ear, kind of a nostril, the jaw. I do think this looks like a fist, right? So I will go ahead and cut it. And this will be the same color as his hand, so I'm going to use the eyedropper. Okay. And then I'll select the cowboy body slash horse situation that's going on here. And I'll try to carve a little bit of arm up and out.
Good.
Okay. I don't know what color I want your shirt to be, but I don't want it to be horse color. So I want to then make a cut here, and I'll give him a prominent belt buckle. Okay, give him a nice blue shirt, a nice brown belt, and then I guess his leg would kind of fall off to the side here. Alright, so make that look like a saddle. Okay, and then his leg. So we want our horse to be the black stallion, so I'll make the horse black. And we want his pants to be red, and I need his saddle to be brown, so I have to carve that. That'll be brown, right? Alright, good. He's got a saddle. His leg would come down. Let's call it this way. This I'm going to try to turn into some stylized version of the saddle, and I'm going to make that brown, eyedropper the brown, and then this will be black, eyedropper the black of horse. So I need to design the horse's face. Maybe I need to go ahead and do an extra little cut here for a light brown of the saddle. Alright, I can maybe even draw a little like saddle horn shape. I'll make it yellow, kind of like brass looking, right? this needs to be cut, and then pasted behind, Control-B, paste behind. Needs to be on top of that, but I guess I just need to bring this to the front.
Okay.
So there's a save. Horse hair, make blue. Okay, so this is his neck, his mane, which I'm going to give it a couple little cuts. Ugh, got to do a better job than that. One, two, three. Okay. So all those little pieces that I just cut, I'm going to turn those black again. If you ever look at the old Superman comics, the Superman had black hair, but their hair is almost always shown with blue highlights. They choose to show it. So I'm going to follow suit. Alright. So we got an eye. We need a crazy eye for the horse. So I'm going to make it have. Get the blob here. I want to look back at the rider like, what are you nuts, buddy? So there's your crazy eye. Now, you know what? Maybe we want the eye to be red. This needs to go behind that. Ooh, I like where we're going with this. Alright. Group that together. Put that down on the horse. Yeah, the horse doesn't really like what's going on with this dude, but that's okay. Alright. So I'm just looking at another crazy rider. And I don't know what horse teeth look like either, but I'm going to do my best to cut some out. So let's go ahead and give him like crazy horse mouth. And then go ahead and make him look kind of like a vampire. Spiky teeth. Alright. He needs a horse nostril. So I'm just going to draw. So I've got this weird, crazy, smiling horse, and this crazy, blonde-haired rider. This will work as a triangle tessellation. I do need to group it. Now, if I take this and transform, rotate 60 degrees with the copy, the horse and the rider should fit in one of these sides or the other. Horse and rider. And on we go. It is sometimes going to be cool to switch it up. Maybe I'll make this guy a brunette. And I'll make this horse a pale type of gray horse. Just need to switch a few more things. Yoink. Click the white arrow. Give that the same fill as that. And then this guy's mane will be orange, whatever we want, green. Brown. Different brown. Got a nice gold gradient, whatever works. Okay. So the only thing that's weird is that I have this random piece of orange kind of in both of these. I'm going to go ahead and hit D, make it default black, so it'll just be like a white shade. I'm not sure what I want to do with that yet. Maybe I don't want red pants. Maybe I want green pants. And I like green shirt.
Okay.
They're different enough now that I feel comfortable repeating this process. So transform, rotate. There are two triangles. 2 times 60 is 120. I'll make a copy. And I'm going to do that one more time. Right click, transform, rotate. 120 copy. This group of three should be able to work as a pattern. So if I take them, group them, all click and drag. That should tie together. Ooh, it is. And see what's fun about this is it looks really crazy. You can barely tell where the original triangles came from. So this is what I want you guys to do with one of your shapes. I may even try to make a pattern out of it. Okay, I'll goof around that maybe a little bit later. But this is a good example of what you can do with your knife tool. I will do another one using these other shapes in a separate video because I don't want us to have like a 90 minute video of demonstrating or already about 15 minutes. So, copy paste. Okay, once you get your group of six, you know it works, there's no gaps. You can just start tiling it before you know it. You'll have a whole bunch of crazy repeating tessellated little folks. So have fun.
Pretty crazy, but a lot of fun.